Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video features my updated favorite free Mac apps for 2019. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for more content just like this. I'm running through this top 9 list in alphabetical order with a bonus honorable mention at the end. First up is Alfred. Making its debut in 2011, Alfred is an oldie but a goodie. Think of Alfred like your Spotlight search, but a million times more powerful. A very, very quick highlight for you is that you can of course search your Mac, but also search the web, complete currency conversions, calculate equations, customize your searches, launch applications, use hotkeys and keywords, and even perform system commands. These are just some of the features the free version of Alfred can do. Getting familiar with Alfred will definitely show you why this is an award-winning efficiency app. You can also upgrade to the Power Pack for between $25 to $40. Next up is Bear, offering a suite of apps for iPhone, iPad, and Mac. Think of Bear like a souped-up version of Notes. I was a big Notes user before finding Bear. So the biggest differences for me are the customization options that Bear offers, the markup options, as well as the organized tagging system. For example, with Bear, you can use searchable hashtags within the body of your notes to help you quickly find your other content relating to that topic. P.S. You can also use Bear for to-do lists and so much more than I can cover in a quick overview. Now, if you want to sync your notes across all your devices, like the Notes app does automatically, for example, you're gonna have to upgrade. Third on the list is Cheat Sheet, all one word. This app is all you need to become a master of keyboard shortcuts. With Cheat Sheet, just hold down the command key on your Mac and you'll instantly get a list of shortcuts customized to whatever app you're in. Next on the list is my new best friend, my favorite password keeper, Dashlane. Think of Dashlane like a free LastPass, but prettier and I think more user-friendly. With the free version, you can manage up to 50 passwords and autofill any personal information on a device. It's the perfect app for my Mac. Now, if you want to sync all your passwords across multiple devices and manage unlimited passwords, you can upgrade to the $5 a month version. Coming in at number 5 on the list is DayOne. If you're into journaling, you're definitely going to love this free iOS app. You can set up daily reminders to journal and document big milestones in your life. You can add pictures, see a map view of where that memory took place, and categorize entries by tag. Even cooler is that DayOne will remind you of things that happened back on this day. The next app to make the cut is called Franz, with a Z or a Z, depending on where you're from. Franz allows you to manage all your messenger services in one spot. We're talking WhatsApp, Messenger, Slack, Gmail, that's right, your emails, Skype, Google Cal, and more. Forget signing into multiple clients, just continue numerous chats from one central hub. Yes, please, I'm obsessed. The next one on my list is a fun one, Giffy Capture. As you might have guessed, it's a GIF-making app. All you have to do is drag and resize the window box over the area you want to capture and hit the record button. You can edit the GIF and either publish it to Giphy or download it. Voila! Okay, this next one is for all you music lovers out there. Use Audio to stream your favorite radio stations. When I'm not editing, I like to listen to music, and Audio is a really cool way to find and listen to stations around the world. There are a few ways to find stations, like by country, language, or tag, and once you have your stations added, you can easily flip through them with very little lag time. I live in a place where radio isn't the best all the time, and we're often behind the new music, so Audio is a great way for me to add my fave stations from back home and keep up with what the cool kids are listening to. Plus, I can listen to my news from back home, too. Last, but definitely not least on my list, is Todoist. This is a really tough call between Todoist and Wunderlist, but I just love the interface and some additional features of Todoist so much. Todoist is the ultimate task manager for Mac. You can easily set up recurring events just by typing a little reminder like pay Visa bill the first Monday of every month. You can easily get a bird's eye view of upcoming tasks. You can also organize your tasks with filters and tags and create subtasks and headers. And Todoist even integrates with your Amazon Echo device and other apps. So those are my 9 favorite free Mac apps for 2019. But I did promise you a bonus honorable mention, and here it is, Chrome. That's right, I still use Chrome as my number one go-to browser. Let the hate comments begin. But now I really do want to hear from you. Let me know what free apps you use in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and you can click right about here to subscribe to my channel or up here to watch another video. See you next time.